Hello, I'm Christopher from B&A, and this is the Irvine Platzhirsch. This is a short video to look at what makes this bike so interesting and special, and also who the bike's for. So the brand is Irvine, which is probably a combination between urban and Wahnsinn, which is a German word for insanity. So urban insanity, and the model name here is Platzhirsch, which is a type of animal, a deer. So the first thing you'll notice is it's an e-bike. In fact, you probably don't notice it at all. It has a rear hub drive motor from the brand of Mahle, and that's a 250-watt motor. So in conformity with the European laws, giving you pedal assistance up to 25 kilometers an hour. A lot of e-bikes today, they tend to have the mid-drive motor located around here that directly drive the cranks. And so here, this drives the rear wheel. And there can be a bit of debate about the advantages or pros and cons of the mid-drive versus the rear wheel. The advantage here is that it's a very, very elegant type of design integration without the big part here. And in combination, it works very, very well. And the combination is with the Gates carbon belt drive. So what you'll notice is it's not a chain, rather it's actually a belt. So it has quite a different system. The advantage of this is it's actually very, very easy to maintain compared to a conventional chain. You don't need the oiling. And in this case, it's got no gears, so no rear derailleur and extra bits. So it's very, very easy. Now, obviously you'd be thinking, if I don't have gears, that makes it a bit harder, but that's where the motor comes into play. You get a lot of extra support through the motor, and combined with this single speed, this single gear, it's actually a very, very good combination. So another highlight is the integrated light. So if I just click on here for a moment, then the lights will turn on in just a moment in the handlebars, and also in the rear on the seat post, I've got integrated lights, and that's a really, really smart solution. So as long as the battery has power, I've got lights and I don't need to think about it. So a nice solution, but perhaps the absolute highlight of this particular bike, in fact, the trademark of the brand, it happened to be the 3D printed bike. So all of these type of round tubes, they're standard tubes, but all of the intersections down the bottom and around here, this is all 3D printed. And it's done so well and integrated so nicely, I can't see any joins. So you could compare it to an old frame which had the lugs and you put the tubes in. This also has a type of format where I put the tubes into one another, but it's so beautifully worked that it's hardly noticeable. And one of the advantages of that 3D printing is you can really define the functionality of the tubing and all the lug work here, so that you can get this really unique type of design without the typical seat tube going all the way down there. So it's a very, very elegant bike, and you could probably guess, yes, it suits a certain type of rider, somebody who's into a bit of style. This comes with a price tag, so it's around about €6. And I would suggest that the type of places and situations where this type, where this works best, are in urban environment where you might have some undulating hills for people who are on their way to work and coming back, who just like to get around town in style. Where this bike will start to stretch the limits is when you get into mountain bike off-roading. Now, although the tires here are relatively generous with a good tread, that actually makes them a good crossover between the road and going onto trails, for example. But when the trails get challenging and very difficult, then that's where it starts to reach its limits. But it does a very, very good job of being able to be suited to many environments. On very, very steep hills, and if you live in an extremely hilly environment, and you probably want to have a lot of motor power, so you put all the way up to the top power, that will really drain the battery. And so that's going to have a limit there. But in many urban environments and cities, and this is a very, very nicely suited bike. It does have a few extra details, such as in here, a few little bolt points, and I can mount an additional mudguard, for example, and even a rack if I wanted to. So overall, an elegant bike. I've really enjoyed testing this and riding it. So for the full review and all the details, you can go to B&A and look for the review of the Irvine Platzhirsch. Otherwise, I hope you like this short introduction, and I look forward to seeing you next time. So click the like button. Bye-bye.